incredible thing, always, to stand on this bima, particularly this evening. My dear friends and family, as many of you know, and you've heard this evening, I'm fond of writing, and I love a good thank you letter. My grandfather, Lewis M. Green, set the bar awfully high for such letters. In fact, I have a file at home in which he thanked my parents, his son and daughter-in-law, Barry and Betty, after pretty much every one of his birthdays. He thanked them for the attention they gave him and for giving him the gift of my sister Jackie and me, his granddaughters, who adored him well into his 102nd year. Tonight, as you honor me on 18 years of service to this sacred and awesome congregation, I can only hope to honor Grandpa Morris's example with a thank you letter of sorts. In our siddur, in our prayer book, near the end of the Amidah, we come across a prayer of gratitude that begins Modim Anachnu Lach. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for being the God of our ancestors. That prayer reminds us that our lives are in God's hands and expresses gratitude for the miracles that we experience every day, for God's deeds and favors at every time of day, evening, morning, and noon. I love this prayer. I love that the prayer acknowledges the miracles of evening, morning, and noon. It reminds me that there are miracles in my life at all hours of the day, and to give thanks for them. For let's face it, I'm sure it might be for you as it is for me, there are days my eyes are open to the miracles of life, and there are days I need some reminding. Tonight I need no reminding. Tonight, I'm grateful for the miracles and moments I have shared with all of you, with our community, for more than 18 years, since a meeting at the Mason's house. Over 18 years ago, even before I decided to interview for the position. As your rabbi, I am blessed to have been with you in the brightly lit hours, times of joy that we could say parallel morning. Aside you at the Ark, aside your children at the Torah, singing with our wee ones, creating new ritual and retreats, cooking or jumping into costume, as Patty mentioned, conversing with loving brides and grooms, choosing names for new babies as the babies and parents sit in my office, smiling at each other, climbing Masada, working alongside our students who have become our teachers, our camp counselors, our unit heads, and camp directors. I'm blessed to be with you in the dark times of tumult and grief that we might liken to evening. In the ICU, as you gain strength to find new steps or movement. Sitting in the living room, sharing family stories and memories of a loved one. Standing at a gravesite, wrestling with family dynamics, unpacking teenage tumult, considering how to make life's next journeys, wondering how to make a new start, and sharing tears and prayers of memory. And I'm blessed to be with you in the in-between times, the afternoon moments, as they were, rich with the daily encounters of teaching, feeding the hungry, nurturing those in our own congregation, building bridges, wondering about the world, creating opportunities to grow ourselves and strengthen our community. As I've asked you to do things, invited you to step up to leadership to strengthen our community, or invited you to learn or participate, even nudged you hard to become an adult bar bat mitzvah. We've updated one another on our lives, be it in the hall, over the Onik Shabbat, or coffee, in a conversation, or perhaps in the streets of Glencoe or Highland Park. In formal or informal conversation. Throughout it all, we've wrestled with belief and meaning. We've argued with ideas and tradition. And yes, many of us have argued about words and grammar too. We've brought our voices to tradition, no matter our age, our gender, our interest, our background. And we've allowed our voices to be heard together, equally, no matter who we are, where we came from. Again and again, we've created new ritual, we've created new teaching, and we've brought our experiences to bear on the sacred literature of our tradition, on the holy words of our people. Again and again, we've created small pockets of community within this large, wonderful congregation. Truly my proudest moments in these 18 years. All of these times, all of these doings are sacred. All are miracles. Thank you. And these miracles have come about, yes, with the divine, with God, and in partnership with you, with all of us, with the people, my partners on this sacred journey. Wendy, David, Ryan, who's here in Texas for his brother's 40th birthday, as he should be, Roberta, and let's be clear, Stephen Patty, you may be retired, but you're in this group. My clergy and educational teammates, who challenge and inspire me every day. You make me laugh. We share irreverent honesty, a work ethic, and our own brands of creativity. And we all want to make Jewish meaning in sacred moments and make our world better, inspired by our Judaism. Every morning, afternoon, and evening, and yes, often late into the night, it is indeed a miracle to work with you all and count you as my dear friends. Lisa Guzman, my assistant and friend. When I desire to make anything real around here, it's all possible when you, Lisa, are behind me or in front of the scenes or behind the scenes. A particular degree of gratitude to Lisa for reading my mind, my handwriting, and my dreams for this community. Amy and the office and building staffs you lead, you are a group dedicated to this congregation and to one another. Gracious always and looking to say yes with a smile to make anything happen in large and small ways. So often in ways that nobody else sees. Together, we all create and connect folks across the ages, interest, and involvement in our community. Susan, Neil, Andrea, all of our teachers, we are joined in a passion for reaching out with Judaism, with joy, with meaning and mitzvah to our youth from newborn, we just heard one of them wonderfully, through our college and beyond, to them and to their families. We share enthusiasm and determination to forge new paths, teach, and engage in innovative ways. Jody, Lorelei, all of our leadership today and those I've worked with in these 18 years, all of you who step up to the task of leading this sacred congregation with vision, with purpose, and with more hours than anyone here can imagine for what is called volunteer. You do this with seriousness and precision, with the love of our people and our community. You, our lay leadership, believe in NSCI, and you have entrusted me for over 18 years to teach, create, and engage Jewish lives with meaning and doing. I'm humbled by your trust and confidence every day. I'm awed by your creativity and love, including the top secret celebration I knew very little about tonight. Led by an incredible team, led by Joyce Palakoff, Peggy Rubenstein, and Patty Mason. Makers of beauty and meaning in so many facets of our synagogue life. I thank you. I thank you, our North Shore Congregation Israel community, for all of your partnership and leadership. For all of you who've stepped when I crazy idea or who came into my office and said, I have a crazy idea, who've worked together. I thank you all for the trust you place in me each day, at every time of day, to join together to make miracles happen. And I thank you for something else. Thank you, my NSCI community, my friends. Thank you for being the community for my family. So many of you have stood beside me in community with my family as I got to know you, as I married and divorced, as I celebrated births and mourned deaths, and most magnificently, as Noah, David, and Talia grow as children of this community, finding and creating their Jewish voices and their roles in repairing our world. Your presence, my community, is and has been the most sacred gift of all. My deep gratitude to family, to friends who have become family and family who have become friends, to my colleagues who are my teachers and friends, and all who have come to celebrate with me. So many of you in this sanctuary, and some who are here, thank you, Marla and Dave up there for streaming, thank you, for those who are here via the miracles of technology. All of you deepen my joy beyond words. Lastly, maybe, while we celebrate the miracles of 18 years, please indulge me a personal expression of utter gratitude. So many of you have heard, as you heard Patty speak, you've heard me speak from this bima and other places about the powerful personal and rabbinic example of my father, Rabbi Barry Hewitt Green. Indeed, Dad's presence is here tonight, I'm sure. He's hearing me. He's sitting right about where Susan Longo is. That's where he would listen to my Rosh Hashanah sermons in the rehearsal. He's probably thinking I should be speaking slower. Happy I put lipstick on and telling me to end with intention, a really good ending. Fewer of you have heard me speak about an equally important presence in my life, that of my mother. We're both crying now. An unassuming person who would prefer to be in front of a group if they're 5 years old. She taught kindergarten for decades, magnificent. Mom, I'm the teacher and mother and storyteller and baker I am because of you. Thank you. A day does not go by without my appreciating the miracles of your life, your wisdom, your humor, your health, and your presence. And yes, your reminders to make sure my suits are cleaned before Rosh Hashanah. Noah, David, Talia, I know we're all thrilled that Grandma is here and Aunt Jackie, my sister, and my nephew Jacob are here from D.C. And as for you, my three precious children, I'm walking a fine line here, everyone else. You all teach me, you make me laugh, and you humble me every day. You are kind and compassionate, curious and creative. I am proud and blessed to be your mother. I am grateful to you and for you. And so, with an awareness that my grandfather would have already told me that I went on way too long, I will conclude. Moda ani lachem. I thank you. I thank all of you. My community, my friends, all of you for the miracles that we share this hour, this day, each hour, each day, each year. For the miracles you've given me, we've made, and we celebrate together. And for this magnificent Shabbat of celebration. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Shehechiyanu V'Kiyamanu V'Higiyanu LaZman HaZeh.
Amen.
I'm indeed grateful to be alive, to be sustained, and to have been brought to this incredible day. Incredible Shabbat of joy. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.